Okay, so what have we gotten ourselves into? Well, we're in a whole nother technology zone here, folks. That's right, I have a whole nother computer hooked up with a whole nother camera, hooked up with a new installation of OBS, and I have absolutely no idea if any of this is going to work. I do know that the clicking noises are going to be much louder, so y'all just get used to that, because it's going to happen. And we'll see what happens here. This is literally a whole brand new, another, like, what the heck are we doing with this mess? And is there any way of stopping it? Oh, let me adjust something here. This is going to be even more entertaining in a moment, because I'm, like, tweaking the size of the screen here, as you can see. Well, all right. Close enough for rock and roll. Yeah, we'll call it good for now. Let's do that crossfade, shall we? Hi. Yes, it is me. I am here. I'm here now, and facing a slightly different direction. And I have stuff behind me. And we're still in the process of getting all of this sorted out here. We're now at a slight angle, aren't we? Which side needs to go up? Welcome. I have a little folding tripod upon which I have my iPhone. My iPhone is currently running a little app called OBS Camera, which means that it is effectively the camera for my webcast, which is happening right now. Now, to make life even more interesting and confusing, I am currently dealing with multiple issues here because I have two screens, one here, right where I'm looking at, and one over here, Gotta figure out where my perimeter is. And so I will glance over there to see what's going on, and I glance back to you. Eventually, I'll have the camera kind of right in the middle of everything, so it'll always look like I'm looking at y'all. I could probably do that now, and since we're already in the midst of technical wizardry and faldrawl, I figure why the heck not. Welcome to learn while you're not earning a damn thing, actually. Although I did actually earn some money because some people were very kind to me, and I'm very happy, I'm very thankful for that, their generosity. There we go, look at that. Now it's level, now I can look at both screens, more or less, and it looks like I'm actually talking to you. Like I, yes, Kay's over there holding onto his screen going, ah, no, don't make the thing wobble. It is literally on this little tripod, which is just like balanced on a card table, because we have that kind of production value here at the Troubadork show. I still have the expensive microphone. It's over here, just out of shot. Oh, all right. So, yeah, I was messing around with slobs, and now I'm back to OBS because I happen to like... yes, the sign behind me, you may have noticed over here, is actually from the Tobias Anchor Sea Shanty Sing-Along Show, which happened one time, and that's probably the only time it's going to happen. But I got the these things for $5, so it was, like, really inexpensive. And so we have a few of them, and I've just clipped them up in front of the rolling racks full of stuff that we have been... storing things in because, well, you know, go ahead and just use everything we've got for as many opportunities, every chance we can get. Alrighty, now, let's see here. I have this, and you see the cursor there because we're not that good yet. And, yeah, let's do that first song. See if I can get through this. Now, once again, I have an interesting situation in that I have two screens. I have one camera, one ukulele, and no sense whatsoever. So what the heck? Let's see how we do here. Can't face another drunk with an axe. Parade is coming and I can't relax. Can't sleep, tent's not up. Dirt and Gatorade are in my cup. And psycho patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, better make way, make way. Good gentles, make way. Hey, 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 psycho patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, better make a way, get out of the way of the parade. Yeah, 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 yeah. You start an improvisation, you can't even finish it. You're shouting a lot, but you're not really saying anything. When I have nothing to say, I'll improv and mime. If it's funny once, it'll be funny again. Psycho patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, 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 better. Make way, make way, good gentles, make way. Hey, hey, hey. Psycho patron, God give you good day. Huzzah, huzzah, better. Make way, make way, get out of the way of the parade. Yeah, 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 yeah. Did you make that? Do you live here? Hey, are those real? Where's the beer? Posters say come out and play, and they drop $50 to walk around and stare all day. Oh yay, oh yay, oh yay, oh yay, oy vey. We are hot and we are tired, and there's a thousand crazy people in the Shire. Psycho patron, God give you good day. Better make way, make way, get out of the way. Say, psycho turkey, God give you good day. Huzzah, huzzah, better make way, get out of the way. Jeez, of the parade. Yeah, 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 didn't die and nothing. That's good. I am sitting just at the corner where it's like bumping into my head here. Ow, ow, ow. Let me try. Better. Okay. Whew. Yes, indeed. Yeah, I did the Sea Shanty Sing-Along Show one weekend just to see if we could get away with it, and the entertainment director was very kind. Found some budget money to pay for me to do it. I think I may be doing more music these days just in general. Partially because there are a lot more magicians out there. Comedy magicians are now much more dense on the ground than they were when I started this 18 years ago. Still doing the magic act on occasion, which means I continue to claim to be a professional magician. Sorta. Semi-professional. But I have discovered that if I'm playing and I don't have a big thick crowd of people and they're all cheering, it still counts. But if I'm a magician and I'm performing and there's nobody there, that's a cry for help. That's not perceived as performance. That's perceived as an issue. So, but I'm enjoying this. I'm having a lot of fun with it. And I think that that's really the bottom line, because I'm 52 years old now, and I've been doing this for a while, and I think I got to consider where I go from there. So that's where we are, and that's why I'm doing this right now. So let's take a look. I believe the first three songs all begin with the letter P, and I don't think I'm wrong here. Yes! I do like this song a lot. Of course, K can be even more smug, because K had a very significant hand in pointing me at the little cartoon of the Platypus Postman from the webcomic 2 a.m. Shower, I think it's called. Maybe 3 a.m. Shower. It's on the Facebook, and I've linked to it like 4,000 times. Neither rain, nor snow, nor sleet, nor hail can make the platypus postman fail. Even in the flood, he's still not stuck, 'cause a platypus postman swims like a duck. Platypus postman. Platypus postman. Even through the mud, they can't be beat. Yeah, they never sink because of their webbed feet. Not a dog will chase him or leave a mark, 'cause the hounds are too darn confused to bark. Platypus. In the coldest rain, they won't live here, 'cause they're protected by their thick coarse fur. Of all the air post carriers on the scene, only one of them is a monotreme, and he's a platypus postman. Believe in the platypus postman. Every day he's a platypus postman. I love my platypus postman. What would Jerry Garcia songs sound like if Jerry Garcia was just as wacky but didn't do quite as many drugs? Yeah. Like that. Like that song right there. This is eventually, when I record these, they're going to go, this is along with Goat Tube and Goat Tube, a overwhelming surplus of Diggity, and a few dozen other songs. They're going to go into an EP called The Internet Writes My Songs, because an awful lot of what I do is inspired by stuff I've seen on the internet, because I am on the internet, because I'm a computer nerd. That's my day job, so I see a lot of this stuff, because I actually have to legitimately stare at a computer screen far longer than is healthy. The next one is one I did yesterday, and I realized as I was playing it that I was not singing it right. And that bothered me. That bothered me rather a lot. So much so that I actually got to the point where I felt that I needed to redo it, basically as kind of a redemption round, because if I don't do the song right, then I just feel like I have significantly let myself down, I've let the folks that listen down, and I have also let Captain Peaches down, because it's his song. So I gotta do the song right, you know? So this is, in fact, the Ballad of Captain Peaches, Redemption Round. Because, well, you know, why not? Let me see here. There we go. Okay. So I'd started to do like my standard ADAD stuff, which I'm talking about the chords here and not attention deficit disorder, which I don't think I have. I think I'm just weird. We sing of thieves and noblemen who sail abounding seas, but this here ditty ain't about a single one of these. I sing of daring swashbuckler who spans the boundless reaches, mighty, mighty corsair, who's known as Captain Peaches. So batten down the hatches, boys, and dust the chandelier, for piracy is stylish whene'er the pirate's near. He'll smite down any scalawag and leave the ladies speechless. There's not a pirate as daring as the mighty Captain Peaches. He sails the endless bounty on the mighty raging queen, a ship the likes of which you poor land lovers never seen. She's got got 16 gilded cannon, and the deck is always clean, and tea is served quite promptly every day at hour 19. So batten down the hatches, boys, and dust the chandelier, for piracy is stylish whene'er that pirate's near. He'll strike down any scalawag and leave the ladies speechless. There's not a pirate as daring as the mighty Captain Peaches. Queen Margaret's royal hairdresser, his bravery knows no bounds. His enemies quake when his cry to the pits of them resounds. Yes, Peach Pits. The fear his enemies have when at his mercy quite compound, for he leaves his captured foeman better groomed than when he found. It's a touch-up. So bend down the hatches, boys, and dust the chandelier, for piracy is stylish whene'er that pirate's near. He'll strike down any scalawag and leave the ladies speechless. They're not a pirate as daring as the mighty Captain Peaches. His ship in Scarborough Harbor has a special pride of place, as it can't see very, feel very far with pastel curtains made of lace. But the captain and his ship is art, and we never would deface. And once he pays his dock fees, he'll depart from this place. Then he'll be free to go. So batten down the hatches, boys, and dust the chandelier, for piracy is stylish whene'er that pirate's near. He'll smite down any scalawag and leave the lady speechless. There's not a pirate as daring as the mighty Captain Peaches. So batten down the hatches, boys, and dust the chandelier, for piracy is stylish whene'er that pirate's near. He'll smite down any scalawag and leave the lady speechless. There's not a pirate as daring as the mighty Captain Peaches. Well, I have fun with that at least. And Captain Peaches has not yet heard the song. So I've now done it three times, twice roughly the same and once completely different. And whichever one he hears, I hope he likes. Really, because let's be honest about this, we're all kind of just making this up as we go along. It's my favorite word in the whole French is bricolage, which is the art of making something out of nothing. And bricolage in this instance also means construction. You build upon things, you put one thing onto another. Brique, I guess, is French for that. I don't know, Japanese is my second language, just bear with me on this. So, I can never tell if this is going slower or faster than it should. But I'm going to do one more song, and then we're going to call it a week. We're changing up how we're doing things here at Casa del Adequacy. We had been making Friday the day when we all go out into the world, and we're kind of adjusting it a little bit here and there, because HEB, the grocery store which has everything in the known universe, if you're a South Texan, you know this and you appreciate it and you love HEB as much as we love HEB, are expanding their hours. For a long time, they were like 8 to 6, and we used to get up stupidly early on Sunday to go to the grocery store because there's nobody there. This is when HEB was open like 24 hours, and they pushed their hours back to open at 7 o'clock, and we're kind of hoping that 7 o'clock on a Sunday, we have roughly the same number of people as we usually have at 6 o'clock on a Sunday, which is, say, not a lot. So that's our thought. That's our theory. So we'll see how that goes. I love that. You love the cursor zinging around here as I try to get myself organized enough? You know, I should just, move the window about, but I can't be bothered to do so at this point. We're still very much figuring out what the heck we're doing here. It's a whole different set of technology now. The camera is actually wider than the display. It's over there, so I have to kind of ooch that around so it kind of balances out, and then I got to put the sign in the right place over here, and then I got to figure out where I'm going to sit, because if I sit over here and I'm cut off, and I sit way over here, and you can't see me at all, so, and yes, behind me there is a door that's labeled bathroom, because that we label things when we expect our guests to interact with them, and in the studio, then the studio room is a studio for crafting, not for broadcasting. We have a restroom, and it's labeled clearly. Aren't you glad you hung out to hear me say all of that? I know I am. You're basically justifying my existence right now, and I kind of like that. All right. I am going to attempt to not sing this so dang high. I know I'm a tenor, short neck, broad chest, natural range, somewhere of B natural over high C, if I think about it hard enough, and then properly motivated. I have been trying to sing this song the way that I hear it when Joe Walsh sings it, and I'm not Joe Walsh. And also, I'm kind of, at this point, I'm usually a little more hyped up because this is usually the last song I do. If I do it in a set, it's going to be the last one. And I got to do it a little bit calmer. I'm going to try to. It's like burlap. I just get so freaking wired on it. I'm going to try to do an intro for it, and we'll see how that works, so just bear with me here. Oh well. Doesn't count if it's not messed up. we have staggered to the end of yet another Troubadork non-commute show. I am going to be working from home, I think, for the next 2 weeks at least, regardless of what anybody else says or does, because the people that are paying me for the day job say I'm going to be working from home for at least the next 2 weeks. So, I will continue to do this. Y'all can continue to watch it if you like. I appreciate the fact that you want to watch it and that you're spreading it around. And every time I see one of these little things come up on the feed, I notice that the number gets higher and higher and higher. Now, I don't know if views means they actually watched any particular length of it or clicked on start, said, well, screw this, and, you know, swipe left or swipe right or whatever it is you crazy kids do with your apps these days. But I have a good time. Hopefully you have a good time. And by the end of this, I might actually have an act. So let's talk about this a little bit. I do have tip jars on service. People have been crazy enough to give me money. So far, that's Robert and Rick and Emily, you magnificent lunatics. Thank you very much. Anything that goes in the tip jar goes to setting up more equipment so that I can do this better. Eventually, we'll be in a different room and we'll need to put in lighting and stuff like that. Most of which I'll be able to cobble together from the random crap that I have. But hey, you know, it's kind of like, it's like crowdfunding, only there's no, like, continual, like, begging. I hope. You've got soundcloud.com/MatthewLaguerre for all of the stuff I have recorded so far when I record additional tracks, including a lot of the stuff that I've been playing right here. So I figured out how I can get away with doing that without running into legal problems, for the filks at least. I will be putting that up there as well. Like I said, we've got an unreasonable surplus of diggity. We've got ham. We've got I Got No Pants, the blues tune that I did. One of my first multi-tracks, which was just way too much fun because I basically started heckling myself during the show. Reaver Johnny Reaver and four-part harmonies up there. A lot of stuff. Check it out. You can find the old shows, of course, at facebook.com/TobiasTheAdequate. I am uploading them to the YouTube channel, which is right up here in tiny print, youtube.com/MPLaguerre on the Troubadork playlist. That's happening about, like, every week or so, which is cool because it means that I can just get the stuff up kind of in one big swat and see where we go from there. All right, so Carpe Diem Comics is, of course, the official emotional support comic shop of the Troubadork show, Tobias the Adequate, and everything else we've ever talked about. And you can find them live in McKinney, Texas, because tomorrow they will actually be opening the store, I think. They might be. They're definitely doing curbside, and they definitely have a website, which is right here. That's their store. Check them out. Support your local comic shops. Support your local gaming shops. Support your local craft stores. They don't have a giant corporation behind them, and the way things have been going with all this money getting thrown around, they might just get lost if you don't help them out. So do check them out. Buy gift certificates, if nothing else, because gift certificates are a present to your future self. It's a true story. So let me talk about Patreon, of course. I have a Patreon. Who doesn't have a Patreon? I currently have four Patreon patrons, which is more than I had when I started, so I feel like that's a positive achievement. If you have disposable income or know someone who has disposable income and low standards, point them at my Patreon page, because all it takes is just $1 a month, and you too can say, yeah, you see all that dumb stuff he did on the video? Yeah, I help support that. John and Brian and Lorena and Alicia are my current Patreon patrons. I'm very grateful to them for their generosity toward me. And I think that's about it. I mean, really, I spent a lot of time getting all this set up, and I'm pretty sure I can get it set up again. And eventually things are going to change. They will continue to change as we do this, depending on whether I'm here in this room or in another room or if I'm, you know, what the heck's going on. But again, see you guys Monday. I'll do this again. Maybe you'll show up. And if not, you can always catch the replay. I think it's been a lot of fun so far. I hope you've enjoyed it. I certainly have. So we'll just do that little quick crossfade over here to the card. And we'll do that part right there. So we got a little bit of branding. Then we'll crossfade to the black so that I can put the little cards up that YouTube likes me to have. And I will see you guys next week. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. And be kind, because if nothing else, it confuses the heck out of the mean ones, and then they can't be very effective. So that's kind of cool. Yeah, that's deep enough for this. Groovy.